So we have discussed about the zones of protection where we have to place the relay. Okay, so now in this session we will discuss about the what are the types of protection. Okay, so what are the types of protection and how it will be backup. Okay, so primary protection and backup protection. So how will we protect the power system from primary and backup? So here what is mean by primary, what is mean by backup. So we'll first draw the okay. So in the generation, transmission and distribution, so we'll having the one type of die, but whatever the primary protection, that is we are placing the in between the generation, transformer and transmission distribution. So we'll place the relay, but in case of if primary relay is failure. Okay, so if primary relay is which is related with place, if it is fails, so what will happen is total equipment will be damaged, right? So for this purpose, so we'll place the another protective system. Okay, so if it is any primary relay is failure, so we have to protect that another equipment, so that will be collected from that one. Okay, so for this reason we will take the backup protection. Okay, in the backup protection, so we'll having the another relay which is connected to the near to the primary one. Okay, so in the primary and backup. Okay, so there are the three types of backup protections is there. So first one is the remote backup, second one we are having the relay backup system, and another third one we are having the breaker backup. So here in the three types, that is the remote backup, relay backup and breaker backup, so mainly depend upon the situation. Okay, so we are having the primary protections, right? So in the primary protection, if it is any relay is failed, so we have to protect that equipment from that one. So for this relay, for this type of protection, so if the primary protection is failed, so we have to protect that with the another equipment, that is the backup one. So here in the general purpose, so in the for mobile application, so in our daily use, so what happen whenever the charger is a battery batteries is totally out. Okay, so if it is charging is totally completed, so if it is our mobile battery is zero, so what happen, so at that time if you don't have any charger in our pockets, so we'll take the backup, right? So in the types of power banks, so for the backup protection. Okay, so if there is any we do protect the, okay, so we need the mobile contention, but so if it is the power charges is there is no availability that's at that time, so we have to put the charging. So for this system, we'll carry the power banks, right? So similarly in the power system protection also, if primary relay is failure, so we have to totally not if it is a primary relay fail, so it will causes the total damage of the system. Okay, so to protect the system, okay, so we need to produce the another backup. So that backup system is called the, we are having the three types. So that is a remote backup, relay backup, and breaker backup. So in the remote backup system, so we'll having the remote backup system. Okay, so the relay. Okay, so backup relay. So we are having the two types of relay. So one is the primary, another one is the backup. So the primary relay is the place the near the centers. Okay, so wherever the main source of the protective equipment, there will be. Then another backup relay. Okay, so another backup relay is placed at the nearer to the located one. Okay, so whatever then here remote backup is placed at the neighborhood station. So if it is the station is whatever the main station. So another backup protection is nearly placed at the neighborhood station of that one. Okay, so at this time, so the primary backup is failed. Okay, so neighborhood station, the fault is continuous flow that. So at that time, so backup protection will start and it will avoid the fault. Okay, so it will stop the fault and clear the fault. Okay, so from that one, if it's failure of the primary system's failure, okay, so continuously we the equipment does not fail, so we have to place the backup system, right? So here another backup relay. Okay, so we are placing. Okay, this type of another. So we are having the relay backup system. In the relay backup system, so this one is the placed at the station only. So in the relay backup, so we are placing the additional relay. So whatever the relay is there, okay, so we are putting, so primary relay, so nearly we are placing another relay for the protection of that primary relay. Okay, that is the type is that is the relay backup. And breaker backup, so breaker backup is nothing but, so whatever the circuit breaker is we are collected for the relay to equipment. Okay, so equipment, relay, and circuit breaker. So if it is circuit breaker is failures, okay, so primary circuit breaker failures, so same another, so this one circuit is breaker is there. Okay, see that parallelly another circuit breaker we are placed. Okay, so for if it is any failure of the primary circuit breaker. Okay, so for that purpose we place the another extra circuit breaker if any primary fails. Okay, this type of protection is called as the breaker backup protection. Okay, so we have talk about the first, that is the remote backup system, relay backup system, and breaker backup system. Okay, so these are the three types. So in the remote backup system, so we are placing the near the neighborhood station of the relay. Okay, so in relay backup, so we will provide the another extra relay to the primary backup protection. Okay, in the breaker backup, so we are providing the another extra circuit breaker to the protective equipment. So these are the three types of the backup protection. So if you take how it will be connected, okay, so protective equipments. Okay, so let me see you. So how it is work, okay, circuit breaker. So during the normal condition and during the fault. Okay, so how if you are seeing the screen during the normal working condition. Okay, so how it is there. So if here in this example, we have taken the one bus bar. Okay, so bus bar protection. So how it will be connected? So relay is connected, circuit breaker. How it is there? Okay, so here you can see the bus bar. Okay, so you are seeing the bus bar and here is the circuit breaker, CT. Here this one is the another, we are having the PT will be also connected. Okay, so this is the relay coil, and here is the trip coil. Here is the battery. So circuit breaker and relay. So if the fault is occur, okay, so how it will be before the fault and after the fault. Okay, so how it will be trip coil. So you can see the bus bar. Okay, so series. Seriously connected to the that is a circuit breaker, right? And circuit breaker is all. So circuit breaker is having the contacts, that is a moving contact. So another we having the fixed contact. So here is a tripod coil that is connected with the relay. So relay. What will do? So relay will take the signal from the CTs and PT. So here one is showing the CT. So if it's PT also connected the parallel to the line. Okay. So CT from that CT. So we'll take the current. Okay. From the current, how much current will flowing? Okay. So is it the predetermined value or the extra value? Is it flowing? Okay. That will be taken. So from that one, if there is any variation in the predetermined, okay, so this current transformer sends the how much current variation, okay, and that will be given by the given to the relay coil. Okay, so relay coil, it energizes. Okay, so relay coil energizes based upon the input of the current transformer. Okay, so from that one, so here tripping will be, okay, that will be the circuit. Okay, so that will be given to the tripping coil. So if it is there any variation in the predetermined value, okay, so and signal from the circuit breaker, sorry, current transformer, so that will be given to the trip coil. Okay, so if any variation is there, the trip coil, okay, so that relay coil will be energized. Okay, from that one the signal is given to the trip coil. So from that one, so the contact, okay, so moving contact will be move from the away from the fixed contact. Okay, so here this is the how is the relay coil state. Okay, so you can see that in the diagram. So the battery is product. So here always remember that the relay coil and circuit breaker, so both will be given this supplies as the DC. So for that purpose we are placing the in the substation will provide the DC supply. Okay, so we need this substations for DC. Okay, so for protective equipment, okay, wherever we need the circuit breakers, relay contacts, we need the DC supply. So for this purpose in the substations we'll place the separate room for the batteries. Okay, okay, so during the fault condition, so how it will be, so you can observe. So during the fault condition you can see here the circuit breaker, so the here if the fault is occurred in the CT, okay, so the relay coil energized and contacts will be closed. Here the trip coil, so here trip coil is also energized due to that. So here the contacts, so fixed contact, moving contact, so moved away from that. Okay, so from that the fault, okay, so whatever the fault is occurred, that will be away from that. Okay, so the whatever the fault is occurred, okay, that is not flow free fault section to healthy section. Okay, so to energize, so to de-energize our variation. Okay, so if it is far after fault is clear, okay, so from that one, so we'll get the signal, that is the relay contact. Okay, so after the fault manually we will switch on the circuit breaker. Okay. So continuity working of the relay. So we are having the how, what are the requirements of the relay. So we are having the this one. So selectivity, speed, sensitivity, reliability, simplicity, and economy. So here these are the requirements. So if relay is failed, so total equipment will be failed. Okay, if this equipment causes damage, so it will affect on the power system stability, right? So for this purpose, some requirement will be there for the relay. Okay, so these are the selectivity, speed, sensitivity, reliability, simplicity, and economy. So these are the requirements for the choosing the relay. Okay, so we can also call as a selectivity as a discrimination, speed for speed operation of the equipment, and we have to sensitivity also required, because if there is small variation in the current and voltage, okay, that we also sense. If the sensitivity, low sensitivity means, okay, so that will be equipment, if it is small transient variations also there, okay, that is also sensed by the equipment. Okay, so if it not sensed, what happens, it will causes the major damage of the equipment. Okay, so for this reason we need the sensitivity having the required. Okay, medical and reliability. So if it is a protective system, must having the their own reliability. Okay, if the reliability is not there, so it will causes the damage. Okay, so so whenever here, not only the reliability, okay, so it will having the stronger connection. Okay, so if it is a failure for each fault, okay, so it will be failure for three times if it's transient fault is occurred. Okay, so if it's failure, so what will happen, say we have to replace the another relay, so it causes the economical cost will be there. So for that one, so it should have in this some reliability, it having the stronger in the operation and fast in operation should completely. Okay, so the F take the simplicity, so it should be in operation should be in the simplicity, okay, not in the difficulty in the combination of line. Okay, the economic, because whatever the equipment we are placing, okay, so if you are placing for protective relay for the generator, so we should take the that amount of rating. Okay, so cost also should be in a not greater than the generator. Okay, so it should be in a 10% to 20% okay, of the generator rate. So whatever the cost of the equipment, sir, so in that one only 10% of the cost will be have to matter. Okay, so for that one it should be in a economic. If protective equipment only having the 100 rupees, okay, sorry, if the equipment is the cost is the 100 rupees, so if the protective equipment is placed the 90 rupees, means there is not economy. So that person, that it should be an economical. Okay, so whatever the protective equipment we are placing, so it should be in an economical way. So why we need the selectivity? Because so the system can be divided in the following protections choose, right? The generator, low tension switch gear, transformer, high tension switch gear, transmission line, distribution line. Okay, so for that is the selective protection. Okay, should in the their own region should have to work. Okay, so for this when it should have the selectivity. Okay, so speed operation, so if the relay should, okay, relation should disconnect fault section as fast fault. So if transient fault is occurred, okay, nothing. So if it continuously fault is occurred, okay, so at that time also should we have to take place there. Okay, because it will cause the major damage of the equipment. Okay. So speed necessary. Okay, so we are having the carrying the fault high longer. Okay. So let me sensitivity. So it is the ability of the relay system, okay, to operate with the low values of the actuating quantity. Okay, so sensitivity of the relay is the function of the volt amperes input to the coil of the relay coil to the cause the operation. So whatever we are having the inputs, that is the CT and PT. Okay, so should be having the within the limits. Okay, so for lower value also it should be work. So for this, when we need the sensitivity, should one of the requirement of the relay. Okay, so here is a measure of the sensitivity, and here is the reliability condition. Okay, so it is the ability of the relay system to operate under the predetermined conditions only. Okay, and the simplicity. So the relay system should be simple to as can be maintained. Okay, so if it is a rigid constructions then, okay, so it should it cannot be right. Okay, so here, here it will the cost are not more than the 5% of the total cost. Okay, so this is about the requirements of the protection. That is, which should have in these following requirements, that is selectivity, reliability, sensitivity, stability, fast operation. Okay, that is the speed and economy. So here we are in the some of the applications we have. Okay, so before we have talked about the relay coils, right? Okay, dear students.